What up, YouTube? It's your boy Tony. We back with another one. Dave, Lesley. Now, y'all been telling me to check this out for a while. Just now getting to it. It's 11 minutes. Damn. So, I'm going to try not to stop it as frequently or whatever, but y'all tell me it's storytelling. So, I'm looking forward to this. Dave is one of my favorite UK artists, one of my favorite rappers. After I heard him in the Black Box, ciphering in the Black Box, and then I listened to Black, and then I heard Psycho and all that shit. Like, dude's on another level, and he young, bro. Bro's 21, 22. Like, there's no ceiling for this man right now, bro. Only that people don't know about him as they should. Like, y'all better wake up. So, looking forward to hearing this, and seeing what kind of storytelling abilities he got, because I have not heard this yet. Like, I guess in Psycho, he kind of was telling his story. Like, how do you stop, like, all the pain? Like, all that stuff like that. Like, how you, like, get off the wrong foot, you don't want it to heal. All that shit. Like, he got wordplay, he has emotional, he got delivery, he got it all to me. And he just speaks to me a different way. So, I'm looking forward to this. Let's just hop right into it, because it's 11 minutes. So, Wolfpac, there's normally a longer breakdown slash reaction channel because I play the whole song, try to catch all the bars if I can. Otherwise, Wolfpac, help your boy out in the comments below. If you're into those type of longer breakdown slash reactions, get a more in-depth look into the song, go ahead and subscribe, go ahead and turn on notifications. All right, Wolfpac, let's go! Like this beat already, ooh!
Look, they say the universe, it works in a strange way. And it must be true because we ain't from the same background or same place. But me and Lesley ended up on that same train. I'm talking every day. I used to wake up around 7 or 8 to catch the 906 from Norbury Station. Two different worlds in the same location. And one day we ended up speaking. And I would talk about college, she would talk about meetings and how she's planning on leaving. How she hates what she does, but she needs it. I asked her what she would do when it's the weekend. And she said, I don't know myself. I don't know myself no more. She used to be the life of the party.
Y'all hear? I don't know myself. He can sing too, bro. Or harmonize enough for you to feel it, like. But he said he got on this train with this woman named Lesley, and they started talking, and you know what I'm saying, they're from different side of the tracks, but they're on the same track that day, you know, at that moment. You know, I'm guessing because she's like upper class, going to work, whatever, and he's young black man coming, like struggling or whatever, and he's trying to get to where he's going, but at that moment they're on the same train. They are the same, going to, you know what I'm saying, the same location. Pretty dope. It's dope. And he said, he asked her, like, what you doing for the weekend? And she just said, like, I don't know. I don't know myself anymore to know what I'm doing.
I don't know myself no more. She used to be the life of the party for true. And now she going out hardly ever. Her man got her in the yard forever. And her friends wanna help, but it's hard to tell her. Hard to let her know that her man's possessive and aggressive. And she can't even see it, but for them it's clear as day. She's in a situation. Her friend Hannah had a man that was manipulative. So she can see it from a mile off. Turtleneck jumpers, makeup around the eye spots. All the signs were there. But Lesley made it seem a light affair. Said it wasn't right to share. Her boyfriend, he was a mystery man. Didn't know much about him, but he's been in a can.
Boyfriend was a mystery man. Don't know much about him, but he's been in jail before. So David's saying that this girl, that Lesley, is like being controlled by her spouse, by her boyfriend, whatever. He said he always keeps her in the yard. Like, he always keeps her in the house. And he's always doing this to her. He's controlling and possessive. But she can't see it from her perspective. She can't see it. You know what I'm saying? But from the outside looking in, it's obvious what's going on. It's clear what's happening to her. To her friend. What did he say? Hannah? Anna? Whatever. Hannah or Anna. It's clear to them and to her because she's been in a relationship like that before. She knows the signs. Makeup on the eyes and all of that shit like that. Covering up the abuse and everything like that. And that Lesley just sweeps it under the rug as if it's no big deal. Like, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. It was my fault. I made him mad. Don't worry about it. You know what I'm saying? So people can't help her, because you can't help people until they want help. You know what I'm saying? You can want it for them all you want, but until they want to get out that situation themselves, they're not going to leave. And then they will resent you for even trying to make them leave, which is crazy, right?
A boyfriend he wasn't missed, but Lesley made it seem a light affair. Said it wasn't right to share. A boyfriend he was a mystery man. Didn't know much about him, but he's been in a can. Name's Jason, he's a bad boy with no reasoning. To be honest, I don't know what Les sees in him, cause she's a good girl with a sweet heart. But they both got demons in a deep past. You know, opposites attract, apparently. Never heard her talk about her family ever. He was all that she had. Until they had an argument and he stopped calling her back. And I don't know if there was more to the story than that, cause she plays things down, but according to that, he went missing one day in the morning he ran. She's doing overtime, struggling to afford in a flat. Till she lost her job, it fucked all of her plans. Couldn't pay the rent, borrow.
Hold on, Dave. You telling the story, boy. You telling the story. The man that she's going through all this abuse for, all this pain for, to stick with him and by his side and protect him and all of that. They had an argument and then he left. And now she's struggling to pay bills. He said he's struggling to pay for the flat. Like, she's struggling to maintain because without his income, he's left her basically ass out, like just figuring it out. But the way he's telling this story is reminding me of, like, Tupac's Brenda's Got a Baby. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's insane. Like, to me, that's one of my favorite storytelling songs, as deep as it is, and it's, you know what I'm saying, like, it's real, though. You know what I'm saying? It's people out there like that. Like, he's 12 years old, and she's having a baby, in love with the molester who's sexing the crazy, and though she thinks they'll be together, like, forever, whatever, he left her, and she had the baby solo. She had it on her bathroom float and didn't know so. She didn't know what to throw away and what to keep. She wrapped the baby up and threw him in the trash heap. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's crazy. She was being molested and then, you know what I'm saying, had a baby with her uncle, thought it was going to be this. He left, whatever. She ended up having a baby in the bathroom and tried to throw him away. But she couldn't get away from it. So it ends up, if you never heard the song, it ends up in a tragedy because she's trying to do this and that, but her parents don't want her to stay. And so she tries to sell drugs. She ends up getting robbed and, like, all she has left is to sell her body, and then she ends up getting killed. You know what I'm saying? So it's like a tragic cycle there from the get-go. And the way Pac told that story was amazing. And the way that Dave is telling this so far is crazy. And I love it. So, yeah, that's insane. This is going to be a long one.
He was all that she had until they had an argument. Never heard her talk about her family ever. He was all that she had until they had an argument and he stopped calling her back. And
So he said his name was Jason. And then, like, Dave said he don't know what he sees, what she sees in him. But I guess it's the fact that they both have, you know what I'm saying, family issues. So they have a common ground somewhere.
I don't know if there was more to the story than that, cause she plays things down, but according to that, he went missing one day in the morning he ran. She's doing overtime, struggling to afford in a flat, till she lost her job, it fucked all of her plans. Couldn't pay the rent, borrowing and calling for cash, but Hannah, she was there for her. Ooh. Care for her. When I saw Les, she told me, I don't know myself, I don't know myself no more.
So she lost her job, and she ended up having to borrow money and stuff like that because she couldn't afford it no more. So she's going through all this struggle, and her friend Hannah, not Anna, Hannah is there for her and, you know what I'm saying, took care of her. And, like, she's just telling Dave again, like, I don't know myself anymore. I don't know what's going on anymore.
I don't know myself. I don't know myself no more. Les saying I got nothing to live for. It's been raw, but David, I ain't never been this poor. There's no income. My boyfriend left me, so how the fuck am I gonna survive when his kid's born? And I said it's a blessing, as mad as it is. And Les, I never even knew that you were having a kid. Bro, she's 4 months pregnant, young and neglected, single, but I don't think she wants to accept it. So she's still texting exes, trying to get this back on track, but I don't think that she gets it.
This boy Flo right now, bro. He is in a pocket, bro. He's in his bag right now, man. He's saying, she said, Dave, like, I ain't never been this poor. Like, I've never been through this before. I mean, like, I got a baby on the way. I don't know how I'm going to have to, you know, how am I going to be happy right now in a moment like this? When I'm at my lowest, I can't even be happy for the kid. And Dave said, as mad as it is, like, over there, that means, like, as crazy as it is, like, you still got to be happy for that baby because that's a blessing. You know what I'm saying? And Dave was just saying, as mad as it is, you got to be happy. That's a blessing right there.
But David, I ain't never been this poor. There's no income. My boyfriend left me, so how the fuck am I gonna survive when his kid's born? And I said it's a blessing, as mad as it is. And Les, I never even knew that you were having a kid. Bro, she's 4 months pregnant, young and neglected, single, but I don't think she wants to accept it. So she's still texting exes, trying to get this back on track, but I don't think that she gets it. It's emotional obsession, clinical depression, life.
Bro, Dave is perfect at just letting the moment sit with you for a second and letting the beat breathe. Like, he does that, like, perfectly, better than any rapper I know, where he just lets it, he lets the beat go for a little bit, just let everything sit with you, and then he comes back with more, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's crazy. This is how he just lets it sit after he tells you her part.
Then X is trying to get this back on track, but I don't think that she gets it. It's emotional obsession, clinical depression. Life is a lesson. And you ain't gotta sit and cry. It's Lesley living in this gift called life. There's no better gift than the gift of life. So can you handle it? I don't know myself. I don't know myself no more. But that changed her perspective. Late in December, her baby's expected to drop. She's accepted, excited, electric, pumped. Only gotta wait a few months. Her and Hannah had lunch.
So he said he was able to change her perspective by telling her, like, you know, in this gift of life, like, the gift of life, wordplay, in this gift of life, the gift of life is a blessing. And, like, it's gonna be okay. Like, can you handle it? Like, can you do it? Like, are you going to step up and be this child's mother or not? And he said, like, he's changed her perspective. So now she's all happy now. And the beat is changing in the song. He does that too. Like, when the mood changes of the lyrics, the mood changes in the beat. It kind of, like, gives you, like, a movie feel.
It electric pumped. Only got to wait a few months. Her and Hannah had lunch. Told her she's pregnant. And they're the closest of brethren, so she didn't stunt to tell her. I think that it's an error. You ain't a mum for a day, you're a mum forever, whatever. And you and Jason break up whenever. If I'm honest, that's something you should have done together. She doesn't know that her and Jason going out again, and Jason doesn't know that Leslie's carrying a child for them. Ooh. She had daydreams of settling.
So she told Hannah that she's pregnant with Jason's kid. And Hannah, like, almost got upset, like, okay, but, like, I wish you would have thought about this, because you're not just a mom for a day. You're like, you're a mom forever. Like, you got to be able to do this, almost like downing her. Like, she can't do it or whatever. Like, and when you and Jason break up or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Whatever y'all doing, like, kind of like spoiling her parade there. Like, but she doesn't know that Lesley and Jason are back together. And then she doesn't know. And then Jason doesn't know that Lesley is pregnant with their baby, which is crazy. What is she waiting for?
And down with Jason doesn't know that Leslie's carrying a child for them. She had daydreams of settling down with Jason. Better because now they're together, it's wild. Feeling like she needs to call her friends and tell them, because wow, she's letting them down, but most of them are never around. She calls Hannah the next day. Still trying to figure out the best way to tell her that she's getting back together with an ex-flame. So she left her a voicemail, like, yo, Hannah, it's Les, can you call me back? I want to talk about the baby, you, me, Jason, all of that. I've been feeling like I need to get my aura back. I used to be so fucking confident, but these days, I swear that I don't know myself. I don't know myself no more. It's free.
Dave is killing this right now, bro. He is painting a perfect, vivid picture, bro. A vivid picture of his lyrics right now, where he said, you know, Lesley and Jason are back together, and she feels like she needs to tell her friends that that they are back together, because otherwise she feels like she's letting them down, that she's back with them in the first place. So she wants to let them know, but they never answer. So she left, and it was dope how he did the voicemail for Hannah or whatever. Like, yo, Hannah, it's Lesley. Call me back. You know what I'm saying? I feel like I need to get my aura back and all of that stuff like that. So she left a message on her phone, stuff like that. So it's almost like, are the friends really there for her? Like, they never seem to pick up for her, like she said. It's crazy.
30. Lesley was meant to get a scan, but today I think she's going home early, trying to talk to Jason, tell him about the kid, addressing any reservations. Had that conversation middle of the summer and it's raining, waiting at the train station, hella cancellation. So she gets a taxi, sitting in a backseat, blue jean jacket and a maxi, actually tired and her legs are aching. Touch the destination way faster than a cab driver's estimation. She put the key in the door, she couldn't believe what she see on the floor. Some size 5 trainers, raging, tears in her eyes, but it's cool, cause they must be the neighbors. And Jason's in the bedroom, fully naked, Lesley running up the stairs, but she's making noise. And she can hear Jason's voice saying, hide in the closet, but he's made his choice. So she bursts in, saying, what kind of person would cheat on his pregnant girlfriend, Jason?
No. Okay. She then took this man back. Happy as hell. They're having a baby. She's supposed to have a doctor's appointment or something like that, but it got done early. She ended up getting to the house even earlier than normal or whatever. And she's going to tell Jason finally that they are having a baby, and so they can talk everything out and, you know what I'm saying, just figure out the nuances of how they're going to be a bigger family. And when she gets there, his shoes on the floor, and she's running upstairs, and she hears Jason telling somebody, get in the closet. So he's cheating again. Oh, fuck.
Jason's voice saying, hide in the closet, but he's made his choice. So she bursts in, saying, what kind of person would cheat on his pregnant girlfriend, Jason? Saying, what the fuck, you're pregnant, what the fuck? You weren't even gonna tell me, I mean, what the fuck? What do you want from us? Nah. You ain't in love, you just wanna love. Lesley telling Jason, I don't wanna love. I don't wanna you and I don't wanna us. And also, I don't wanna talk loads. One more line before I dash like Morse code, open the wardrobe.
One more line before I dash like Morse code. Cause you know, Morse code, they... Oh, what? That's... Oh. See... When she told him that, when she said, came in the room and said, what the fuck, like, you're gonna cheat on your pregnant girlfriend, and Jason got mad at her, he, like, flipped the roles on her, like, what the fuck, like, you're pregnant and you didn't even tell me, like, you don't want love, like, you don't want to love, like, you just want, or, like, you're not in love, you just want somebody to love, you're like, you just need somebody, like, you just need me, like, but you're not really serious about being with me because you would have told me that you was pregnant. And she, like, I don't want anything from you no more. Like, I just need to say one last thing or one last line before I get out of here. Like, he said something like dash slap like Morse code, which was dope. Fire.
One more line before I dash like Morse code, open the wardrobe.
Oh, time to open the closet.
Jason's on the edge. I just want to see if she was prettier than me, slimmer than me, maybe your baby similar to me, maybe you wanted someone thicker than me, fitter than me, to satisfy you quicker than me. I got your baby in my stomach and you did this to me. What did I ever do to you for you to finish with me? I didn't believe my girls, but they were thinking of me, and give it to me, the wardrobe, give me the key. I was pulling at the door, but Jason's bigger than me, literally, I remember viscerally, Jason pulling from behind me, now he's gripping on me, white flash. His eye gashes when he's hitting me, see, I just wanted to disappear, I wasn't living for me. Physically, I shut the fucking door as quick as can be. He's outside asking why I made him do what he did, using a kick to open up the room that I'm in. I'm feeling afraid, barricaded with a chair and a handle. I'm hearing sirens, I just want to run away, but I can't. Jason's gone by the time police are coming. They saw that there ain't no one else in the house, and feds are running through the door shouting. We had reports of an argument with a woman. There's blood all over the floor and it's splattered onto the wall. Les, on the bed and she's trying to speak to the feds. She's deep in the stress and there's meters above her head. If anything, she couldn't even say anything. But she's got this really sharp pain where her belly is so. They call her ambulance. Lesley didn't plan for this. Police are in the room trying to find a missing piece of the puzzle until they stumble on something that's kind of random.
I gotta pause it for a second. Like, you wanna talk about taking you on a range of emotions to go from where the story was, just riding the train together, to the downs of him leaving her, to the ups of her being happy, to the downs of him leaving her while she's pregnant, to the ups of her finding out she's pregnant and that she's happy, and then to the flats and to the downs of like being back with him without telling them, and then like to up to trying to go to the doctor's appointment and be happy and go tell him, to just down to where he's cheating, and when she wants to get in the closet to see who she was and just say, and she just asked, like, I wanted to see if she was prettier than me, slimmer than me, like I just wanted to see, like, what was it, like, who is this that has you doing this to me? And that was hard, man. That was them was some bars, bro. That's some writing there. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's pulling emotion out of people. People that have been through this situation, people that have experienced this, will feel that and relate to that. And then, like, when she's trying to get into the closet, he just starts beating her, and she said she wanted to give up, but she's not the only person she's living for because she has the baby in her. Now the cops are there. Apparently he's gone because he was outside the door saying, like, why you make me do that? Trying to put it on her. Like, it's her fault that you fucking beat her and shit. Like you don't have control over that shit. Like, you didn't punch her. But now the cops are there. Dave.
Asking why I made him do what he did. You only make it for me. I didn't believe my. Jason's on the edge. I just want to see if she was prettier than me, slimmer than me. Maybe your baby similar to me. Maybe you wanted someone thicker than me, fitter than me, to satisfy you quicker than me. I got your baby in my stomach and you did this to me. What did I ever do to you for you to finish with me? I didn't believe my girls, but they were thinking of me. And give it to me, the wardrobe, give me the key. I was pulling at the door, but Jason's bigger than me. Literally, I remember viscerally. Jason pulling from behind me, now he's gripping on me. White flash, eye gashes when he's hitting me. See, I just wanted to disappear. I wasn't living for me. Physically, I shut the fucking doors quick as can be. He's outside asking why I made him do what he did. Using a kick to open up the room that I'm in. I'm feeling afraid. Barricaded with a chair and a handle. I'm hearing sirens. I just wanna run away, but I can't. Jason's gone by the time police are coming. They saw that there ain't no one else in the house, and feds are running through the door shouting. We had reports of an argument with a woman. There's blood all over the floor and it's splattered onto the wall. Lee's on the bed and she's trying to speak to the feds. She's deep in the stress and there's meters above her head. If anything, she couldn't even say anything. But she's got this really sharp pain where her belly is so. They call her ambulance. Lesley didn't plan for this. Police are in the room trying to find a missing piece of the puzzle until they stumble on something that's kind of random. It's a phone in a wardrobe. They had five missing
phone in a wardrobe, so the girl must have dropped her phone.
In a wardrobe. They had five missed phone calls from Jason and also a couple other numbers, so they're thinking that is no help. Until they play the voicemail, like, yo, Hannah, it's Les, can you call me back? I wanna talk about the baby, you, me, Jason, all of that. I've been feeling like I need to get my aura back. I used to be so fucking confident, but these days, I swear that. I don't know myself.
Dave, you motherfucker. What? Jason was cheating with her best friend, Hannah. The friend that was there for her, took care of her. They could see the signs of that she was being abused or whatever. But since she went through that situation herself, she also was in a cycle and wanted to be with a man just like that. I didn't see that one coming, bro.
What?
And it was just different numbers. They said it was a couple missed calls from Jason. So Jason's number was saved. Hers wasn't, because she called as well. Because they would have seen Lesley. It wasn't. Her number wasn't even saved. She just was on a voicemail. Yo, Hannah, it's Les. Call me back. Like, that's the same. I said that was dope how he did that. But now I know it was foreshadowing. He did it for a reason. So it can be obvious once you hear it again, like, this is Hannah's phone. That's sick, bro. That's sick. That's sick.
I used to be so fucking confident, but these days, I swear that I don't know myself. I don't know myself no more. She felt sick to her stomach, she started panicking, mind rattling, trying to understand what Hannah did. Battling the shame, cause the situation embarrassing. She's trying to fathom it, betrayed by her own garrison. Meanwhile, she's on the deck trying to manage this. Piercing pain in her stomach, she couldn't handle it. Now she's waiting for an ambulance. Look. And I know she's strong, but when I heard about what happened, I was overshocked. Her nose was gone, her jawline shattered and rot. They said her baby was the reason she was holding on. She's dozing off, doctors getting no response. Her heart rate slowing down and they don't know what's wrong. Picked her up, got her out the home and onto the stretcher for good measure, but she's fading out. She took damage.
She's fucking stressed. She said she was trying to figure out, just overwhelmed with, you know what I'm saying, being humiliated, angry, scared of the baby, sad, her betrayed from her man and her best friend, having sharp pains in her stomach, not knowing if she's going to lose the baby, but the baby's the only reason she's holding on. Dave said when he found out, he knew she was strong, but like, I'm guessing he's seen her. He said her jaw was messed up, her nose was messed up. Like, he beat her down. But did she make it, though? Well, that's for her to give the story of him attacking her. She had to make it.
To the brain, and now she's in a coma measure, but she's fading out. She took damage to the brain, and now she's in a coma as we speak, but I ain't sure if she can make it out. You see, this time that I'm taking out to tell you the story is more than a song or track. It's a message to a woman with a toxic man. I'm begging you to get support if you're lost or trapped. I understand that I can never understand, and I ain't saying that it's easy, but it must be right. Some of your sisters, aunties, mums and wives are fucked inside, and they will never touch on why. I'm touched cause I've seen women that I loved or liked cry a little red tear through a bloodshot eye. This shit's awful. No matter what culture, it ain't normal. Men try and twist it and make it seem like it's your fault. In that train full of people that you're taking, how many Leslies are running from their Jasons?
I don't know what the next 2 minutes could be, but I gotta see. But he said, basically, she's in a coma. He don't know if she's gonna make it out. But he said, I'm telling this story because there's a lot of, I was just on the train going to where I was going, and I didn't know Lesley was going through all of this. There's a lot of Lesleys running from their Jasons on your everyday journey in life, and you may not know it. That's why I try my best to try to be as polite and, you know what I'm saying, genuine to people that I come across, because you just never know what your words may mean to someone. You may save someone's life just by telling them, hey man, good job, bro. You know, I don't know what I'd do without you here, just at work or something like that. You know what I'm saying? Or, you know what I'm saying? Like, you're a cool dude. Like, those words, like, small things like that can, like, change somebody's whole life and give it meaning. Like, you just don't know what people are going through before you make judgments or cast aspersions upon people when you don't know truly what's going on behind closed doors. And he said, you know, I've seen how many aunties, moms, sisters, and all of that are running from their Jason. I've seen my aunt cry from a red tear from a bloodshot eye, like, giving imagery again, bro. Like, this dude is amazing, bro. He's never afraid to speak on real issues, abuse, political issues, You know what I'm saying? Racism, whatever it is, he's not afraid to step on a limb. He doesn't care about how it may, you know what I'm saying, affect his bottom line or something like that, how it may turn off a certain crowd or anything like that. He goes for it. And that's the realness about him. And that's what's up. And he's only 22. 22.
Angel without wings, like the day without the night, a job without this anymore, a song without a voice, a spark without a flame, a child without a name. Oh, it's just wrong.
Well, we've made a massive amount of progress in this last year, haven't we?
And that's the therapy sessions of that it started with. But damn, thank y'all for this one. I think this became one of my top storytelling tracks. I appreciate y'all. Tell me what y'all felt about it. Tell me what you think about the twist, the build-up, the twist, the climax. Like, it's just like, he truly told a story. Like, I just did NF story, and I thought that was dope. But this is like story, just like another level right here. And this is like, it's serious, and it's people can relate to it, and it touches, it pulls on your heartstrings. Like in Black, like when he performed Black at the awards, I cried off it. Because it pulled at something here. You know what I'm saying? Something that we're experiencing right now that I'm going through. And I got a son. And he's, I know, I don't want him to experience that. You know, and go through that. You know what I'm saying? That type of stuff. But like I said, Dave always finds a way. So I appreciate y'all, man. Continue to like, comment, subscribe, and share. Comment what you felt about this. Comment any more requests. Oh, man. That was deep. Wolfpac, we'll be back. Let's go.